I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you the calibration of LVDT. This is the equipment for calibration of LVDT. This is a digital one. This is a mechanical one, where mechanical is converted into electrical one. How? Now, it consisting of a cylinder-like structure with consisting of a plunger and a spring attachment, where primary coil and secondary coils are provided in this cylinder. The movement is carried out with the help of this micrometer, which in turn electromotive force is induced, that is EMF is induced. That disturbance is indicated by using this digital indicator. Okay, and now first I will make this micrometer to the null position. I will bring the micrometer to the null position. The least count is 0.001. First I will make this is to null position. I'll just keep the cameras aside. Okay, I'm making this one is a null position. Null position is nothing but 10 mm. At the 10 I will make it as a 0. Rotate. Now this 0 is coincide with the 10. Now it is 10. I have to make 0 in the digital indicator. Okay, and now it is exactly null position. That is 10 is nothing but I will consider as a null position. Okay, and now this is 0, then in the digital indicator that should be 0 again. Now this should be 0. If it is not 0, with the help of 0 knob, make it as a 0. By rotating this one, make it as a 0. If it is in this way, if any disturbance is there, then you can make it as a 0 with the help of 0 knob. Now it is 0 now. Now, next, same. I will move towards the left. Now I will move the micrometer towards the left. 5 mm I will move. This is the 5 mm. 5 mm I will move towards the left, that is the positive side. Now this is the 5 mm I have moved it. 5 mm I have moved it. Now I have to balance the bridge. Again I will move towards the digital indicator. Now it is around 5 point something, exactly 5. If it is more than that one or less than 5, with the help of cal knob make it a 5. Make it 5. In this way we are balanced the bridge. Now check it out. I'm rotate again back to the null position. Back to the null position, I will rotate back to the 10. Okay, I brought back to the 10. So it is 10 10 10 10. Okay, done. Now at the 10 null position the indicator should be 0. Now it is indicating 0 here. That is the bridge is balanced. Now go for experiment. How the experiment has to be carried out? When I move towards the 1 mm towards the left, half one rotation is nothing but 0.5 mm. Again one rotation is nothing but 1 mm. For 1 mm, what is the reading here? 1.02. Similarly for 2 mm, half rotation, again one rotation, that is 2 mm. Now for 2 mm, what is the reading? You have to say it again. will go for directly now. For 3 mm, what is the rotation? It is 3. Okay, similarly for 4 mm, what is the reading now? 3.99. Similarly, for 5 mm displacement, the answer will be 4.99. This is for the forward stroke. I have done it for the when the core has to move towards the left position. When the core is moved towards the right position, then what we have to do? Okay, I will just zoom it out. I will bring this core to the null position. I will bring it this one to the null position here. Okay, I will just adjust the camera so that it can be seen visibly. Okay, now again I will make the 10 as a null position. Null position 0. Now I'll bring, and the digital indicator is showing the 0. If it is not showing the 0, with the help of 0 knob, make it as a 0. Okay, next I will move towards the right side. 5 mm I will move towards the right side, that is minus 5 mm I will do. That is for 15 mm I have to move here. This is 5 mm I have moved towards the right side. Now it is around 4.96. With the help of Cal knob, I have to make it 5. Okay, it is 5 now. Okay, 5 mm. That means now again I will come back to the original position, that is for the null position, to the 10. Now at the null position, the indicator should be show zeros. Similarly, when I move 1 mm backside, minus 1 mm backside, what is the reading? You have to see it. Half rotation and one complete rotation. That is 1 mm I have moved this side. For 1 mm rotation towards the right, the answer will be 0.99. Okay, next. For half rotation, 2 mm. For 2 mm, the answer will be minus 1.99. Similarly, I will go for 3 mm half rotation, full rotation. So for 3 mm, the answer will be minus 3 mm half rotation, full rotation. For 4 mm, the answer will be minus 4 mm. For 5 mm, the answer will be minus 5 mm or minus 5.01. You can take it out. In this way we have to carry out the calibration of LVDT. And after completion of this one, you can go for correction, error and percentage of error, and you have to draw the diagrams. Thank you very much. I am Santosh Gaidankar.